We're having a nice day. The weather's getting a lot nicer. It was hot this weekend. The weather was hot. The fishing was not. Thinking about talking about the new climber and kind of getting started and maybe my experience, which I know is mine, but like could help somebody maybe. And I guess that's the point. I feel like for the most part that this profession is a learning profession, and everybody seems helpful. I mean, a lot of critics for sure, but that's probably anywhere. I don't really know. But I remember when I was gonna start this business, and I remember going on some forums, tree forums, and I remember a kid, well, I'm assuming he was a kid, but I think he was, I don't know how old he was, but he was younger, but anyway, he asked a question. He said, I have a truck and some chainsaws, and I want to start a tree business, and everybody kind of ripped him a new one and said, oh, you can't start a tree company without at least $50,000 and all this equipment and everything. And you know, I guess for me, I started this company with nothing, and I worked my way up. I was a USDA certified climber. And I had some chainsaws in a truck and the basic climbing gear. And I was able to do it. I only took jobs that we could do with the gear that we had. And we took the money we made and put it back into the business. And so, I don't know if I agree with those people. I'm not saying it was easy, but I'm saying we did it without $50,000. Definitely did it without $50,000. And so, you know, I would say, but hell, maybe I'm wrong, because you know what? The truth is, I've never worked for a tree company. Never worked for another tree service company. And, you know, I don't know whether that was good or bad, but that's what I did. And we started this in 2015. Which brings me up to the other point I wanted to make for the new climber. And that's, I think it's easy to talk about, you know, you see online a lot of people talking about what they know, which makes sense, right? It's probably not a good habit to talk about things you don't know about. But kind of knowing what you don't know seems like is a good skill to have. And, you know, maybe just doing the things you know you can do. And sticking to that till your skills improved. I know that was one thing I still do. I try to stick to with what I know and try to either learn or understand about the things that I don't know about in this industry. Kind of keep learning. I could do trees today, or I feel comfortable doing certain projects that I didn't always feel comfortable doing it. Maybe that limb's all tied up in there. I don't know what's, you know, everyone's experience is different. I just went to a class with some guys who are, you know, much younger than I am, and in the doing the business a lot less than I have, and already done projects that I haven't. It's just kind of how it goes. I always like to kind of hear how people got started. I think it was like Two True Guys podcast or something like that. This young man up in Oregon and bought a company and just kind of went for it. I didn't always I still don't know what I'm doing half the time. Maybe that's not something to say anymore. Up in a tree. But kind of true. I'm just being honest. I had some training through the U.S. Forest Service, just the basic tree climbing class. I wouldn't say there was anything to write home about, but it's enough to get me started and deemed, I guess, proficient enough or safe enough to have a U.S. Forest Service climbing card. think I should be able to get that out of there now. I'd be curious to hear about how you guys got started.
Oh.
You know, my whole approach to things is you gotta start somewhere. You gotta start somewhere, you gotta learn. You're gonna make mistakes. Think is that the wrong attitude? Is a level of acceptance, I feel like, in this job. going. It's going. It's going.